The Derby Red Raiders have swept through their five Housatonic League opponents in workmanlike fashion. While coach Charlie DeCenzo would like to see more points scored by his offense, Derby has the personnel to do the job in quarterback Tony Picariello, running backs Chris King and Ray McGee, and receivers Jamie Gagnon and Greg Pettinella. First-year Ansonia coach Jack Hunt has been pleased with his undefeated Chargers' steady week-by-week improvement. Junior running back Fran Hendricks has provided Ansonia with a more balanced offensive attack and made it possible for quarterback James Lane to make the passing game even more effective. Lane's primary targets are flanker Dave D'Onofrio and tight end Brent Harvey. From Jarvis Field in Ansonia, it's the annual gridiron battle between Derby and Ansonia on Valley Cablevision's High School Football Game of the Week. Again, everyone, Ed Clements along with Buddy Chernovitz from Jarvis Field in Ansonia. Buddy, coming into the football season, the Derby coaching staff thought that their offensive part of their team was going to be the best part of their football team this year. They felt that their defense had some question marks. Thus far in the season, even though the Raiders are undefeated at 5-0, the reverse has been true. The offense has struggled at times. The defense has thus far done a better than expected job for the Raiders. Your reaction?
Well, in the beginning of the year, most of the time your offense takes time to get ready and your defense is usually ahead, and I think that's what's happened to Derby, although they can't complain being 5-0, and I know that Charlie DeCenzo is certainly pleased with the way they've done, but your defense is usually ahead. I think the offense is going to catch up, and they need that opportunity to play a lot together. They've had a couple key injuries with McGee and King that have been playing hurt and going both ways, and I think that may affect their offense more than their defense.
The Ansonia coaching staff, coming into the football season, their number one priority was finding a running back. They knew they had the fullback in Greg Gumas. They have found that running back in the last three football games, Fran Hendricks.
He's certainly done a creditable job for them, and plus that offensive line has been getting off the football for them. They've been able to get into people and given Hendricks the opportunity to run. He's done a super job. Gumas lead block for him, and right now they've got an outstanding running attack going along with that passing attack of James Lane.
Buddy, the key or the keys to today's football game?
I think the keys are for Derby, the ability to run the football. They've got to be able to make some ground yardage. They're going to pass sparingly. Ansonia, if they can throw the ball and run the ball, I think they've got a big advantage. And that's what really is going to determine the football game. Down in the trenches, the offensive line play for both football teams.
And we'll be back with the kickoff between Ansonia and Derby right after these messages.
You're watching Cable 10, the community channel.
Welcome back, everyone. Ed Clements along with Buddy Chernovitz at Jarvis Field in Ansonia for one of the state's top attractions on this weekend of scholastic football. This happens to be our Cable 10 Sports Valley High School football game of the week, Buddy, between two of the Valley's finest, both undefeated, Ansonia and Derby.
And we just found out that the West Haven Blue Devils have upset Hamden High School, giving Hamden its first loss, which adds a little bit to this football game, because quite possibly the winner of this game, as you look out at the large throng of people that are here on a beautiful day, the winner of this football game very possibly could move up into the number one or two spot in the state. So it certainly is, in itself, a traditional game, a big game in the Valley, and the winner of this football game may move into those state rankings as the number one or number two team.
Right now, Ansonia owns the number four spot in those state rankings that Buddy refers to, and the Derby Red Raiders, the number fifth rated team, according to the New Haven Register football poll. Jim Albert will be kicking off for the Raiders. Back deep for Ansonia has won the opening coin toss. It's Hendricks who gets the football and hands off to Billing. Billing with the football, and Billing crosses the 30-yard line to the 34-yard line, where the Chargers will set up shop first and 10 as we get underway in this traditional battle. While we have an opportunity, let's take a look at the Ansonia offensive sets.
Ball about the 35-yard line.
First and 10 for Ansonia. The football spotted at their 34-yard line.
Quarterback for Ansonia is James Lane.
Quarterback is James Lane. Behind him in the I formation, the fullback is Gumas. The I back is Hendricks. And Hendricks gets the call on first down and is stopped behind the line of scrimmage. Luchow along with Battaglino on the tackle for the Raiders. And let's take a look on your screen at that Derby defense.
And number 74, Chris Luxow.
Second and 10 for the Chargers. Hendricks back just to the line of scrimmage. As you get a look at the Ansonia huddle, just underway from here at Jarvis Field. And as Buddy said, it's an ideal football day for, it's an ideal day for football. That is D'Onofrio in motion. Lane back to throw. Has the time. Throwing down deep. Has a receiver out there. It's caught. That's Jeff Billy. 20, 10, Jeff Billy.
Jeff Billings is going all the way, a 65-yard pass from James Lane to Jeffrey Billings with 10:51 in the first quarter, and Ansonia has jumped out in front here with a great pass play, Lane to Billings.
And that is Adam Hallett, the sophomore kicker for Ansonia, kicking the extra point. Check that. Hallett is a junior, 5'11", 180-pound junior. And Ansonia, Buddy Chernovitz, has struck quickly here in this traditional battle.
The first play, they ran it to the line. Very little success. They came back quickly with Lane throwing the football. Billings beat McGee down the center of the field. The ball was perfectly thrown. He never broke stride, was able to outrun McGee into the end zone. And a big play, obviously, to start this football game. Ansonia with tremendous fan support here, and what a way to start for the Chargers, as they have been beaten for the last few years by the Derby Red Raiders, and right off the bat they get out in front.
Pelotowski's kick coming down to Patinella. Patinella with the football, angling over to the Derby sideline. Patinella with some room outside to the 40 midfield before he's finally bumped out of bounds on the far side of the field by Chris Kinnebrew.
Kinnebrew was the last man preventing a touchdown. That was an outstanding run by Patinella as he comes down center of the field and breaks to the Derby sideline. And right here, he is going to be run out of bounds. Great job, but an excellent return. Great field position on the 49-yard line as the Derby Red Raiders begin their first offensive series.
Well, let's give credit to Marty Pelotowski. He rode Patinella out of bounds at that point. Raiders have it at the Ansonia 49 to open up. First down carry, a handoff. That goes to Ray McGee into the center of the line, stopped by John Coughlin. While we have the opportunity, let's take a look at that Derby Red Raider offense. Second and 9 for the Raiders. Coughlin making a stop on McGee after a pickup of 1. Football now at the Ansonia 48-yard line. Just underway from here at Jarvis Field. Chargers scored with great quickness on their opening possession. That's Ray McGee trying to spin away, but he cannot get away from monster back Marty Pelotowski. Let's take a look at that Ansonia defense.
That Ansonia defense is going to be a key. They've got to prevent that Derby Red Raider offensive line from getting in there and allowing McGee King those holes that they've had throughout the first 5 games of the year.
Third and 7 for the Raiders. The line of scrimmage is the 47 of Ansonia. Piccarello wants to throw, has the time, throws out to the near sideline. It is incomplete. It is intended for King coming out of the backfield with Bell on the coverage for Ansonia.
To number 14.
Watch here as Piccarillo rolls. He's got a lot of room in front of him, but he decides to pull up and throw the football. It's underthrown. King never had a chance to get it. Brings up a punting situation. But at least for the Derby Red Raiders, they should put Ansonia back and have pretty decent field position after that excellent kickoff return.
Albert, under a rush by Hallahan, gets it off, and does he get it off? Sends Henrik back into the end zone. It'll be a dead ball there, and the Ansonia will get the football at their 20. What a punt by Albert.
Fran Henrik's made a mistake, too, trying to field the football. Luckily, he got it out of the end zone, preventing a mistake, but he should have never caught the football. Usually coaches put you back in that 10-yard line and tell you if the ball goes over your head to let it go. He fielded the football, attempted to get it, and it rolled out of the end zone. A break for Ansonia.
First down for the Chargers at their 20-yard line. Second possession for Ansonia. That is D'Onofrio. He goes in motion. The give is to Henricks, the eye back. He stopped at the line of scrimmage after a pickup of one. Angeletti, along with Rizzio, on the tackle for the Raiders. Buddy caught up with Coach DeCenzo before the game, and he asked Coach DeCenzo about some of the lineup changes that the Raiders have made coming into this football game.
Buddy, we've changed some personnel a little bit, partly because of the injuries we had earlier in the year. Now we're getting to see some of these kids back healthy. Mark Angeletti, for one, last week we played him just primarily defensively against Branford. Now this week, of course, Mark's going to be going both ways again. That enabled us to move Winston Dawson back to the defensive line where we originally wanted to play him. And Jimmy Albert now is playing some guard for us on offense. And it enables us to split one defensive end between Albert and Luchow. So in the long run, it certainly has helped us in, so that we can get some of the kids out of the game once in a while for water and to talk to them. A couple of weeks ago, we had all those kids hurt. It was very difficult to communicate to the kids because they were never off the field.
Welcome back, everyone. Second and 8 for Ansonia. The football at their 22. They lead in the football game by a score of 7-0. Single setback gets D'Onofrio in motion. Lane wants to throw on second down. Under a rush, gets it out to D'Onofrio. Far sidelines. D'Onofrio still on his feet as he crosses the 35-yard line before he's stopped by Mo Monahan.
Watch Lane gets an awful lot of time, just turns the ball out to D'Onofrio, and then he'll turn up the sidelines, picking up the first down yardage. Excellent run after he caught the football, and that's something that the Chargers have been successful with, and the Red Raiders must take that away in this football game. They can't allow Lane the time to throw and the ability to hit those receivers as they turn out on them to the sidelines.
Line of scrimmage is the 37. Ansonia breaks the bone as D'Onofrio goes in motion. That's Henricks near sidelines. A blocker out in front of him. Dragged down by Angeletti after a pickup of about 4 or 5 on the play.
Number 54, Mark Angeletti.
As Coach this...
Excellent block you'll see here by number 33, Harvey. Look at him turn the end in right there. He's got excellent position, allowing Gumas to get outside with Henricks and pick up very good yardage on that first down toss, creating about a second and 3 yards, and an excellent block by Harvey and Gumas as they led Henricks to the corner.
Again, Ansonia breaks the ball, and D'Onofrio goes in motion. Give is to Gumas, a loose football picked up by Albert from Derby, and the Raiders have the football at the Ansonia 35-yard line.
Albert picked that ball up. You see him going off the field, almost broke free as he picked the ball up right here. The ball is not lost right here. Gumas does not get the football. You see it bounce right here, and watch Albert. He'll get the first hop. And now Lane, unable to bring him down. He's wrestled the ground right here with help from Henricks, saving a touchdown on the 35, 36-yard line for the Derby Red Raiders.
Well, the Raiders have a big break in this football game. Early on, Ansonia leads 7-0, split backs. Now McGee goes to a wing to the left side. King and Del Moro. Del Moro gets the call, rumbles down to the 30-yard line before he's stopped by Hallahan.
Del Moro got in there very quickly for good yardage. Comes off the near side here. You see the kickout block by the guard right inside. Nice tackle in there by number 87 for Sean Hallahan as he prevented a big gain, but a good first down call for the Red Raiders.
Second down for Derby. They have the football at the 30. That's McGee going in motion. And King, out of the tailback spot, rumbles forward for the first down inside the 25 to the 22. Chris
another,
King.
Another big hole inside there, Eddie, as they did a good job. Again, the guard kicking out. McGee coming through with the lead block. Look at McGee kick out on the corner. And here we come through with King for an excellent 7, 8, 9 yards as he drags forward close to that 22-yard line. Red Raiders putting that offense in gear.
And Harold Bell and Dave D'Onofrio finally on the stop, but not before King picked up the Derby first down. In motion, that is Chris King. Scissors play. Ray McGee getting outside. McGee to the 20-yard line before Ansoni gets some help from the secondary. D'Onofrio, fine defensive effort.
McGee set that up very well. Starting inside there, broke to the outside. D'Onofrio with a great tackle. Watch McGee here dip inside. He'll set up inside right there. Now he gets back to the outside, uses his speed. He runs away from the first tackle. D'Onofrio getting in. Beal had a shot at him, couldn't bring him down. About 5 yard gain, and that Red Raider running attack is right where they left off in the first five football games.
Vicarello gives off. McGee out of the tailback spot. Ray spins and leaps over the 15 to the 14 yard line before he's stopped by number 39, Greg Gumas.
McGee just comes in. Now watch right here as he is knocked down at the line of scrimmage and then runs into his own player. Short of the first down, but a very makeable third and about two.
Line of scrimmage is the Ansonia 14-yard line. Raiders picking up a loose football and getting down to the 14. Short yardage needed on third down. McGee has the first down as he slides off the left side. A loose football. And let's see if the fumble came after the play was ruled out. It did not. Ansonia has the loose football.
McGee turned the ball over. You'll see as McGee gets in there and makes the first down right here. As he goes, Del Moro with a great block right there. And then McGee is going to get hit, and the ball is going to pop loose just before he gets on the ground. Ansonia is going to recover it. As you see him all searching for it, there he is right there. It looked like 56 on the football. Dan McClellan, who got that fumble, and a big turnover for the Chargers.
Ansonia deep in their own territory. But they're happy to have the football back. That is Hendricks. He cannot get outside the Ansonia defense. Coming up to make the play was Mark Angeletti along with Nick Rizzio.
And that turnover, the fact that Ansonia got that turnover keeps that momentum a little bit on their side after that big second down touchdown play. If Derby got in the end zone right there, it would have nullified to a great extent that big pass catch from Lane to Billings on that second play of the game.
Ansonia has the football at their 10-yard line, second and 10. D'Onofrio going in motion. We've got flags on the field. There's going to be an encroachment penalty coming up against one of these teams.
Watch right here as he jumps. You'll see the top of your screen right there into the neutral zone. 5 yard penalty. And a big 5 yard penalty considering that the Derby Red Raiders held Ansonia with no gain in the first play.
So it's a second and 5 coming up for Ansonia with the line of scrimmage, the 16-yard line. Lane with time to throw, throws it out. That is Chris Ahern. Ahern at the 30, 40, midfield, 40, still on his feet, 30, 20. Chris Ahern finally dragged down at the Derby Red Raider 10-yard line.
Greg Patinella is the guy who comes back to catch from behind. You'll see it's just a turnout right here. Goes for the interception. That's Patinella who went for the interception. He's going to get up now, and he is going to make the tackle as Ahern goes down that far sideline to about the 11-yard line. Rizzio also back there to make that tackle. Great catch, great run, and great field position right now for the Chargers as they are in position right here to go to commanding lead with only 3:56 left to go in this first quarter.
First down for Ansonia in the bone. Hendricks gets the corner, but then the Derby defense comes up, leading the charge. Ray McGee along with Chris King, both captains for the Derby Red Raiders.
Comes to the outside here. You'll see good lead blocked by Gumas, but excellent contain as McGee comes up right here to force. Only a yard gain. You see Rizzio behind. Second and about 9.
Second down, second and 7 for Ansonia. D'Onofrio goes in motion. Lane wants to throw again. Rolls to his left. Looks over the middle. Has a receiver out there. It is an Ansonia touchdown. Harold Bell.
and then he sees Bell. McGee tries to knock the ball down. Bell there, great throw by James Lane.
And Adam Hellett will attempt the point after. That will put Ansoni up by a score 14-0. The snap, the placement, it's good. And with 3 minutes and 3 seconds left in this first quarter of play, it is Ansoni 14, Derby nothing, back after this. Welcome back, everyone. There you see Jack Hunt, the possessor of a 14-0 lead, but he caught up with Coach Hunt before the football game and asked Coach Hunt if this football game meant anything different to him now that he is the head football coach as opposed to when he was the longtime assistant for the Chargers.
Right now, this is the biggest one of my head coaching career. Derby is, no matter what your record is, you know, you got something you have to live with your whole life. That's what I try to emphasize to my seniors. They're going to graduate this year, and to go out without beating Derby, it's something you have to live with, you know, your whole life, and I don't want that to happen to this group of kids.
Marty Pelotowski, end over end, coming short. Aaron Sill with the football. The 34-yard line, a few of the Chargers combine on the tackle. Greg Millen-Kelvich, number 26.
Was by number 4, 83, David Prairie. And tackle Millen-Kelvich was made by number 41.
Among the tacklers for Ansoni, and the Raiders have a first down as you get a look at the Ansoni sidelines. But they've got to get something going here, buddy.
They had an opportunity. That fumble took away that opportunity, the last possession. They certainly have to crank up a little bit here. Positive yardage.
Out of the tailback spot, that is Chris King.
There's some positive yardage. He's coming from all over here.
John Coughlin along with Dan McClellan on the tackle for Ansoni. That's a personal foul, a late hit by the Ansoni defense.
You see Russ Hansen, the referee, stepping off a personal foul. You'll see the late hit coming in here after the tackle is made right here. There it is. No question about it. It was late on Chris King. And it puts the ball now inside the 50-yard line. And Derby right now cranking up that offense. They need a little bit of momentum on their own side right here as we wind down near the end of this first quarter.
Well, they have the football at the Ansoni 47. That's King in motion. Back to throw as Piccarello has a receiver. Ray McGee. And it's ruled incomplete at the 45 of Ansoni, right in front of the Ansoni bench.
That call was made from the Ansoni bench. That was a great call by the bench. You'll see here McGee coming out. Now, I don't think he lost the ball. I think he had the football, but Ansoni, right on that sideline, yelled incompletion, and the near side official went with the call. He got no help from any of his brother officials.
Second and 10 for the Raiders. They have the football at the Ansoni 48-yard line. King goes in motion. The Raiders in the I formation. The pitch goes to Ray McGee. Ray McGee gets the corner. 45, 40-yard line before he's bumped down at that point.
Tackle made by number 33, Troy Harvey. Also in on tackle number 10, Jake Ruffio.
Excellent blocking out in front of McGee right here. As he turns the corner, he's going to go for about 8 yards. You see right here, he cuts back inside a block right there. Looked like Del Moro, who threw it, gets close to that first down marker, making it a third and about 2 yards.
And it is a third and 2. The Raiders have the football at the 40-yard line. The give, that is Chris King, slides outside. King, I believe, has the first down before the Ansoni defense comes up to meet the play. Dave D'Onofrio along with Marty Pelotowski.
I don't believe they're spotting it where they're spotting. That is the worst spot that I have seen. He was ahead of the down marker when he was knocked back. I hope we have a replay on that because he was definitely ahead of the down marker. And he was knocked backwards. Forward progress should have given him the first down. They are not going to do it. Watch now when he comes to the out of bounds. You see King break the outside. A great run right here. Now watch. He is ahead of that down marker. Look at him. He is knocked back. That's the worst call I've seen. Terrible, terrible call.
So the Raiders are
excellent
going to
replay. Good job, guys. Good job.
The Raiders are going to go for it on fourth and about a foot. They're in four down territory. Line of scrimmage, the 38 of Ansoni. Piccarello wanted to get his offense straight. Piccarello picks up the first down, going straight ahead.
Nice job by Piccarello getting his nose in front. Tony got his nose right over the ball. really, it was he in the center, got a good jump and got in that first down area.
First down for the Derby Red Raiders. Football at the 37-yard line of Ansonia. In motion, that is Chris King. Give is to Ray McGee, trying to center the line. The Ansonia defense meets the play. In on the play, John Coughlin.
Ansonia's playing a 40. They're playing an even front. First time that I've seen them in that in a while. And that is due to, I think, a couple changes in there for them, especially with Stallings in there. They're not playing on that nose. You've got Como and Stallings, the two down tackles with two inside linebackers, and it's a different look for the Red Raiders and a different look for the Chargers.
Second down for the Derby Red Raiders. The pitch goes to McGee. McGee with the football, picks up about three on the play before coming up to make the play, Greg Gumas, senior linebacker.
You see McGee come to the outside on the pitch. Del Moro leading him, turns it up, and he does a good job. And before he's hit, he just gets his head down forward to try and get that extra yardage. But he's still got about third down and almost 5 yards to go here for that first down in four down territory.
Line of scrimmage is the Ansonia 31 to the top of your picture. Now out of your picture is wide receiver Patinella. That is Del Moro. He is stopped in the backfield. Coming up to make the play, McClellan, along with Gumas.
Mark Del Moro.
See McClellan here. He will get a piece as Del Moro tries to break to the outside. McClellan gets him, and then he gets help also from Pelotowski. Lost about 2.5 to 3 yards. And we've got now at the end of a timeout here with fourth as the 4 seconds left to go here. You see Charlie DeCenzo in the huddle. It's a big play, obviously, for the Derby Red Raiders. As they need a first down, they need some momentum right here, as this first quarter has belonged entirely to Ansonia in the big play.
4 seconds remaining. Our scoreboard clock here at Jarvis Field is not the official time. The official time is being kept down on the field.
Any member interested in attending?
And when the Raiders take the timeout and play resumes, the Raiders will have a fourth down. The line of scrimmage will be the Ansonia 32-yard line, and this will be the last play of the first quarter. 4 seconds remaining. Ansonia leads it 14-0. The pass, the big weapon by the Chargers thus far in this traditional battle. Picarillo, McGee in motion, wants to throw. Backside pressure, knocked down. The football is loose. A scramble for the football, and the Chargers will get the football anyway. And that's the end of the first quarter. We played one here at Jarvis Field. Our score: Ansonia 14, Derby nothing. Welcome back, everyone. Buddy,
right here you see Picarillo rolling, and you see backside Hallahan. Nobody's going to touch him. As Picarillo gets ready to throw, he's going to get blindsided. He never saw it. The ball rolls and is recovered by Ansonia, but on the fourth down it really didn't matter. In a big turnover as that Charger defense has bent, but they have not broken here early in the first quarter.
So we start the second quarter of play with the Chargers in possession at their 34-yard line, having a 14-0 lead. Pitch back to Lane, and a pass downfield to Harold Bell. There's some bumping down there, but it's an incomplete pass.
Little bit of flea flicker back and forth. Ball flipped back to James Lane after the handoff. Bell never really ran. He more glided down the field until the ball was thrown. As you see, one of those big hands on your charger. You'll see here the handoff, and then the flip back from Hendricks back to James Lane, and then Lane unloads. Bell down the field is covered very well. Was some bumping, but both players were playing the football.
Second down for Ansonia. The line of scrimmage is their own 34-yard line. Just underway in the second quarter of play. Ansonia leads it 14-0. Godofrio goes in motion, reverses his field. Now he wants to throw on second down. It's a screen. Hendricks with blockers in front of him. Hendricks gets outside, slides to the 40-yard line. Before he's stopped by number 72, Buff Bartone.
Ansonia sets this screen up very well. Watch, stepping out, just out of your picture is Hendricks. He catches the football, tries to break the outside right there, but a great job bringing him down by Buff Bartone, preventing a big play. It's third and five. Ansonia now moving the football very well, both on the run, enough to keep Ansonia or to keep those Derby Red Raiders balanced, but the pass has certainly been the weapon that the Chargers have used here to get up 14-0.
Single setback, Ansonia wants to throw again over the middle. Completion, that's Bell for the first down. Oh, my goodness. Jamie Gadman on the tackle finally for the Raiders.
This is just a little bit of a slant inside the Bell. You see him look to the outside, then he comes right over the middle to Bell. Nice catch, good tackle, but a big first down right around midfield here for those red-hot Ansonia Chargers, and James Lane has a hot hand right here in this football game.
Chris Anderson made the tackle on Bell, and the line of scrimmage is midfield. First down for Ansonia. Out of your picture, to the left side is Bell. In motion is D'Onofrio. Lane wants to throw again. It is picked off. Number 86, Patinella, midfield. Down to the 40-yard line. Reverses his field. Greg Patinella on the interception. Dan McClellan finally wraps up Patinella, but the Raiders have the football back via the interception route.
You see the ball right here is coming out to D'Onofrio. The throw is through him. He does not get it right through his arms. Patinella behind him steps back and he'll cut to the inside right here. Brings the ball down near the 34-yard line as the Derby Red Raiders have a big turnover again.
Raiders have it at the Ansonia 33. I formation. The pitch. Chris King. King trying to get outside. The Ansonia Chargers do a good job on contain, led by defensive end Sean Hallahan. Marty Pelotowski also helping out on the play.
Hallahan showed me a lot there. He, Del Moro took him on solid. As you see Jack Hunt right there talking to his defense. Del Moro took him on solid. Patinella just played off the block and got back in on the tackle. A great job.
Line of scrimmage is the 32 of Ansonia. Raiders have the football after the turnover. Del Moro straight ahead, still on his feet. Good balance by Mark Del Moro. Harold Bell and Hallahan on the tackle.
Watch straight ahead. Del Moro's not a big kid. He runs like a big kid, though. Inside, just a dive trap inside, straight ahead, and he just goes forward close to that first down yardage on a big second down call for the Red Raiders.
And the Raiders have a third and short, the football at the 24 of Ansonia. What a game we have for you on this, our Cable 10 Sports Valley High School football game of the week. Del Moro tripped up at the line of scrimmage. It's going to depend on the spot. Sean Hallahan tripped him up at the line of scrimmage.
Going to be pretty close as they're going to have to bring the down markers out. Del Moro was one step away from making it a big play. Watch right here. Off top, you see McGee and King. Good blocks. Now watch Del Moro try to step to the outside right here, and he just is nicked, loses his foot, and comes very close to that first down. He's going to be about an inch and a half short, creating a fourth down situation around the 22, 23-yard line of the Ansonia Chargers.
So again, the Raiders will be obviously going for it. A fourth and inches coming up for Coach Charlie DeCenzo's Derby Red Raiders. Jarvis Field in Ansonia, an ideal day for high school football and a great crowd here at Jarvis Field. Fourth and inches. King in motion. The give. Del Moro slides for the first down off the left side. Mark Del Moro.
Except for the two big pass plays by the Ansonia Chargers, the Derby Red Raiders have controlled the football on the ground. It's been a big play offense for the Chargers, but Derby has had possession time in this first half, and they have moved the football very well, just been unable to get into the end zone.
Football at the Ansonia 22. Piccarello wants to throw on first down, throws out to the near sidelines, has King out there. King gathers it in for a Derby score. Touchdown, Derby.
That was a great pass from Tony Piccarello to Chris King. Over his head for Ansonia. Onofrio was turned around here. Look at King. And Onofrio loses the ball right there and cannot get back into it. King catches the ball in the end zone, loses it. It's a big touchdown right here for the Red Raiders as it's gotten them back into the game after a number of key mistakes. The extra point is going to make it a 14-7 football game here with 9:24 left to go in this first half.
And Dezado drills it through the upright, and the Raiders are back in this football game. What a catch by Chris King.
Great catch, great eye contact with the football. An outstanding throw by Tony Picariello as he led him to the outside. And Onofrio was just not able to get back into it. But King just reaching up, taking the football in, excellent concentration. And it is certainly a big play right here as the Red Raiders were down around the 10-yard line in the first quarter, fumbled the football, and now they are back in it at 14-7. Take away a little bit of that momentum that the Chargers had with that 14-0 lead. Who said this wasn't going to be a good game?
Not us.
Back and forth. The quality football of the Valley, as you see Charlie DeCenzo there looking out. I know he has to feel a little bit more comfortable right now that he's been able to get 7 points on the board. And I think he has to feel good that his offense has been able to move the ball and run the football, especially against the little bit larger Ansonia Charger group of defensive players.
Bumped out of bounds by McGee at the Ansonia 45. So the Chargers will have excellent field position.
Some excellent special teams here by both groups. We'll see now right here, ball is banged around a little bit. Bell loses it, but Hendricks right there picks it up. Harvey in front of him. Good blocks to the outside as he breaks the sidelines. And McGee there corralling him about the 44-yard line. Minus 44 for the Chargers. They put the ball in play. Their fifth possession in this first half.
Scissors play going to D'Onofrio.
Lost the football. It's a Red Raider.
Raiders have the football.
It's a Red Raider.
Number 81 playing on the football, Todd Hunter.
He never had the ball. He was stripped as he came back on the reverse. A little bit of a scissors play. You see him go inside. He loses it right here. It's stripped from him right there. Number 71 had his hands all over that football for Derby, causing the fumble. And right now, the Red Raiders, momentum on their side. They've just scored. They now have the ball on the plus 47-yard line, and they are back in business.
That was Winston Dawson, number 71 for the Raiders, stripping the D'Onofrio of the football. Coming up with the football was Todd Hunter.
The last time we saw Winston Dawson, he was sitting on the bench with ice on his ankle, and he was kind of a down and depressed young man. And today,
full house backfield. Aaron Sill bounces off
number 20, Aaron Sill.
The defense. Finally taken down by Harvey.
Tackled by number 33, Brent Harvey.
And it'll be a 2nd and 9 coming up for the Derby Red Raiders. What a game we have for you. We knew that these were two quality opponents, both undefeated coming into this football game, both leading their respective leagues in this non-league battle, but big intra-valley rivalry. Del Moro stacked up on the inside, plugging the hole. Dan McClellan from the linebacker spot.
Number 39,
came back to the inside trap. You see Gumas getting up off the pile. A lot of help in there. Del Moro, a tough runner inside. He gets his nose in there. That time he didn't have very much room as the two inside linebackers just stepped right up here to grab him. You see there, McClellan with help from Gumas. No place to go as the two inside people just closed it off.
3rd and 8 for the Raiders. Set the 44 again. Tony Picariello wants to throw. Gets the protection from his
got him out there.
Out there and complete. Just overthrows Pettinella at the 20-yard line. Double coverage by the Chargers.
Ball was just out of the reach of Greg Pettinella. You'll see here, good time. Tony puts the ball up just out of the reach. He was behind both Bell and Hendricks. Ball a little bit overthrown. 4th down situation right here, and Charlie DeCenzo is elected to punt the football.
Chargers drop back. Fran Hendricks back to his 15-yard line. Line of scrimmage to 44, and Albert gets the punt off. Hendricks fields it on a dead run and spins his way up to the 23-yard line. And the Chargers will take over once again. Our score at the midpoint of the second quarter, Ansonia 14, Derby 7, back after this.
Welcome back, everyone. What a game we have for you. Ansonia scoring two touchdowns the first quarter. Derby answering back in the second quarter of play. The Chargers maybe trying to get some running game going here. And that's Gomez just straight ahead. Angeletti, the initial hit for Derby.
Derby has done an excellent job containing the run in this first half. No place to go here. It's just a straight dive to Gomez. He'll try and step to the outside, but he is corralled by the inside. Angeletti right there with help from Rizzio as they put him down. And the Chargers are not really running the football. They certainly have been able to throw it, though.
High formation. That's Hendricks, and he's going nowhere. Hit in the backfield. Lou Badalino, Winston Dawson, Todd Hunter, all in on the play for the Raiders.
Stop made by number 26.
That throwing group you're going to see into the huddle right now. Number 85 Bell and number 20 Chris Ahern. Bringing in a play from the sidelines on a big third down call.
Line of scrimmage is the 26-yard line of passing formation for the Chargers. They've been able to throw. Lane, a drop. Albert with the pressure, incomplete, as Lane threw the ball under pressure, intended for Chris Ahern on the near sidelines, and the Chargers will have to punt the football away.
The punt for Ansonia will be number 16, James Lane.
Sometimes when you jump out to a 14-0 lead, you sort of forget that there's still three quarters left to play, and that may be a problem right here for the Chargers. They have gotten out in front and now have sort of sputtered a little bit on offense. That was their sixth possession, and they have not had that big play in the last four. And the Derby Red Raiders going to get the football back right here.
Fine punt by Ahern on the other end. That is Aaron Sill gets away from the football. And when we resume play, the Raiders will have it. First and 10 from their 33.
Excellent punt without a return. Sets up the Chargers with good defensive field position right here in the Derby Red Raiders. 67 yards away from tying this football game up. 4:48 left to go as the clock begins in this second quarter of football.
First down for the Derby Red Raiders. They have the football at their 33. Second quarter action from here at Jarvis Field. McGee goes in motion. The pitch, that's to King. King has a hole. Breaks it at the 30-yard line. King with it.
Some hugging on that red sideline. The Red Raiders, Chris King, 67 yards on a little pitch sweep. King gets to the outside right here. He's going to get a great block by Del Moro, and he is off to the races. You'll see Bell has got the only chance to get him right here, and he is not going to make it as King, a little bit of burst of speed, and we are close here to tying this football game up.
And a snap. And it's Chargers hold on. They cling to a one-point lead. Coming in to block the punt, giving credit for it, is Marty Politowski.
Not to take anything away from Marty, but that ball never had a chance. Politowski almost hit the ball up to the crossbar. Never really had a chance. It was hit at the line of scrimmage, one of the backs of one of the players. And we will see if that makes a difference in the momentum. The Red Raiders obviously fired up after that long run by Chris King. A chance to tie it. Instead, the ball is blocked. They're still down 1 point, and we'll see if that makes a difference here or whether the Red Raiders keep coming on, because they have been coming on.
We have a second try.
You see they're coming off the field, Edward.
In the picture, that was Todd Gibbons, the offensive tackle, lost for the season, an unfortunate accident, non-football related. And the kickoff fielded by number 88, F.J. Burkowski for Ansonia.
Ball carried by number 88, F.J. Burkowski.
Brought back to the 34, and the Chargers have it on another, still another possession. But aside from the big plays, buddy, the offense from Ansonia has sputtered.
It certainly has, and it's going to be key right here to see if they can get it back in gear. Derby and their defense have done a super job
They've given up two big plays. They've done a super job containing that base offense of the Chargers. And right here, we are ready to go. 4:07 left to play.
Well, Ansoni wants to throw on first down. Incomplete as Lane throws it out to Ahern. And Ahern slams his fist into the turf. Thought he should have had the football.
Second catchable ball as you see Gene Dellavolpe, the offensive coordinator, sending Chris back into the football game on a play. You see just a turnout, a play that Ansoni has made famous here with their quarterbacks. Capola and all of the men that have come along with him, and Ahern just does not hold on to the football.
Second and 10 for Ansoni. They have the football at their 34. Hendricks with the football, dives forward to the 42-yard line, does Hendricks.
Ball's run by number 23, Brad Hendricks.
Sprint draw action that time to Hendricks, with Gumas leading. When that comes off of the sprint, see Gumas kick out right here at the point of attack. And then Hendricks does an excellent job breaking back and getting close to that first down yardage. Third and about three for the Chargers, as that's a big running play for them. And that will put some pressure on that Derby defense so that they must play that run and not concentrate totally on the pass.
Third and short for Ansoni. Lane wants a throw as Ahern for the first down at the 47. Before he's wrapped up there by 54, Mark Angeletti.
5-yard turn in. 5 yards, he will drive down just enough of the first down. Watch Lane, he'll just pull right up, and he nails him with a great throw, but Ahern with an excellent catch, just a quick pitch pattern at 5 yards for the first down. Yardage, Patinella in on the stop for the Derby Red Raiders.
Let me give credit and correct myself that it was Greg Patinella that hit Ahern at that point, and Angeletti came in and cleaned up. First down for Ansoni at their 47. D'Onofrio in your picture, the top of your screen, going in motion. Lane under a heavy rush, gets it out, incomplete to D'Onofrio at the 45 of Derby. D'Onofrio had it in his hands and dropped the football.
Again, another catchable football. D'Onofrio not able to hold on to it. See Lane throwing while he's falling backwards. Great throw, unable to get it. Patinella and D'Onofrio exchanging pleasantries as they go back to their respective huddles.
Second and 10 for Ansoni at their 47. I formation. Lane again a drop. Near sideline, scrambling and running out of bounds because he had no receivers. All the receivers were covered.
That was a great job by Todd Hunter. They were trying to run a screen back here to Fran Hendricks. Hendricks did not really sell the screen to Todd Hunter, so Hunter just stayed with him. Lane had no one to throw to and did what all good coaches tell you to do, is run right at him and force that guy to make a decision. He got back about 3 or 4 yards, but still creates a third and about 15 on a great play by Todd Hunter that time and smelling out that screen, not allowing the completion.
So it's a third and 14 for Ansoni, the line of scrimmage, their own 43. Lane under a rush, gets it out, incomplete to D'Onofrio. What a hit, a major league hit by McGee.
McGee read that very well as the ball comes just before the ball right here is going to be caught. He is banged right there. Great job by McGee, who has been going both ways all year along with Chris King. And one of the things that Charlie DeCenzo talked about was trying to get a little bit of a rest for those two young men, hoping that it would help them both on offense and defense.
Ansoni punting the football away. Lane does the punting again. A spiral coming down in the vicinity of John Sherwin, number 21. Sherwin tripped up at the 17.
Ball was fielded by number 21, John Sherwin. Tackle made by number 20, Chris Ahern.
Chris Ahern on the tackle for Ansonia. So the Raiders have, according to our scoreboard clock, 2:26 remaining here in the first half. Again, a reminder that's unofficial, and you get a look at the wide crowd, the throng of people here, a wide shot.
I don't think you're going to find a seat available on the Ansoni side of the field.
Look at that crowd. This is Ansoni Derby football. Loose football and falling on the football for the Raiders. Being helped up now is Chris King.
With about 2 minutes left, Derby does not want to make a mistake down here. Both teams have played pretty even here in the first half, the extra point being the difference. And the Red Raiders do not want a turnover. Watch here. The ball is pitched out, and no one really wanted it. It looked like it was going to be pitched to Del Moro. Del Moro was leading, and King was the man probably who the pitch was intended for. It was too far away from him, but he did cover it, preventing the big turnover.
Second and long for the Raiders. There's the give to King again. King gets across the 20-yard line. He makes up for most of that first down loss, where he's stopped in the secondary by D'Onofrio.
And Sonia's going to use a timeout right here. You'll see King come up inside. Look at a kickout block right here on Hallahan by McGee, and then King gets his nose forward across the 20-yard line, but it creates a third and a lot, and Jack Hunt is taking the timeout right here. As you see him inside the huddle, they would like to get the ball back and allow Mr. James Lane the opportunity to have a number of plays, a couple of plays to possibly get him some points on the board.
That reminds me to tell our viewers that today's coverage of the high school football game of the week is a presentation of Cableton Sports Valley Cablevision Incorporated. Solely for the viewing enjoyment of Valley Cablevision subscribers. Any rebroadcast or other use of this telecast without the express written consent of Valley Cablevision is prohibited.
And that t-shirt really spells it out for this week in the Valley. If you're wearing blue or lavender, you are a beat derby. And if you are in the red, it's beat Ansonia. It's a football game that everyone here in the Valley looks forward to. It's a quality matchup always between two outstanding football teams, and today is no exception.
And they both happen to be undefeated coming into this football game. Chris King on the sweep, rumbles, and gets some very, very good yardage, close to the yardage.
He gets a good spot. He's going to get that poor spot again, and he's going to be a little bit short. Gonna have Charlie DeCenzo think for a few seconds at least, and then he's going to send that punting team in. Watch Del Moro right here now as he just keeps going. Excuse me, Chris King, keep going. Twist forward close to the 30-yard line of that first down yardage, but he's going to be about, oh, maybe 5-6 inches short, as you see Russ Hansen bringing the ball back. Eddie Mariano and his crew, outstanding group of officials you have on this football game, and it's going to force the punt by the Red Raiders.
And I think I know Coach Charlie DeCenzo well enough, buddy, in dealing with Charlie down through the years, that he is not going to take any chances with that situation showing on the scoreboard clock. He's going to punt the football away and leave it to the defense to hold Ansonia for that minute and 19 ticks of the clock.
No question about it. You have to punt the football right here. You can't afford a turnover or the real problem of not making that first down and giving Ansonia the football inside your own 30-yard line with less than a minute to go. Giving it to James Lane anyway at this point still presents a problem with his ability to move the football. You don't want to give him a short distance of only 30 yards. Force him to drive the field if they need or if they're going to get that score.
Buddy, let me also mention to our viewers that Cable 10's local election coverage will be beginning at 8:30 p.m. on Tuesday, November the 3rd. There will be interviews with candidates, special features, along with local results, all coming your way on Cable 10, your community station.
Anyone interested in making reservations or needing any other information, contact Pop at 35 Mile Street.
Fourth and inches. And the Raiders are up to the line of scrimmage, going for it on the fourth and inches. Maybe they're going to try to draw Ansonia offside. Piccarello, long count. That's what they're going to do. And now the flags, as we had a little bit of a chess game out there. And now the Raiders will punt the football away after you see the delay of game penalty.
They also had two men in motion here. And
we'll take the 5 yards.
Charlie DeCenzo trying to draw offsides the Charger defense. Not getting that penalty, he will now put the ball in the air.
Jim Albert will be standing at his 11-yard line, getting set to punt the football away. A little bit of time left in the second quarter. Ansonia setting up for a return.
Hendricks,
fair catches it. And that was a late decision by Hendricks as he fair caught the football at his 45-yard line.
on the Ansonia 45-yard line.
This will be the eighth possession for the Chargers in this first half. They have excellent field position. They have one timeout remaining with 1:12 left to go, and certainly plenty of time with James Lane and crew.
Now one of the officials is
signaling the clock. They were running the clock. They're pretty close to the field time on the clock right now.
Lane under a rush, throws on first down, broken up. Intended for D'Onofrio, coming by to break it up to Chris Anderson, 5'7", 140-pound junior.
Watch Lane as he rolls here to the near side. He will pull up, throw back. What a great job by Anderson as he steps in front of the receiver, and that was, looked like D'Onofrio or looked like Dave D'Onofrio. Anderson stepped in front of that receiver and almost came up with the interception.
Second down play for Ansonia.
They're going to go for the distance pretty shortly here.
Lane wants to throw again. Ahern on the short pattern gets down to the 47-yard line.
Derby. 20, Chris Ahern.
Stopped there by Chris King.
Chris, that's the third and final timeout for the Chargers as James Lane comes to the near side to talk with Jack Hunt, Jimmy DeLaVolpe. You see Lane right here, a little bit of a slant pattern inside. Great job by Ahern holding onto the football as he was hit pretty good. Was one of the cheerleaders for Ansonia looking on here, and final timeout now for the Chargers. They now inside the 50-yard line with a third down, about 2 yards left to go, and not a great deal of time, 54 seconds left to go without a timeout.
When we resume play here, Ansonia will have a 3rd and 2, the football line of scrimmage at the Derby 42-yard line. And James Lane still talking it over with coaches Hunt and DeLaVolpe right below us on the near sidelines.
You've got two excellent people upstairs too, John Sponheimer and Bobby Lisi, who are talking or in constant communication with Jimmy DeLaVolpe and attempting to come up here with one or two plays that they can use possibly to get down either into the end zone for the touchdown or close enough to try a field goal.
Well, Lane has the instructions from the coaching staff. Let's see if he can put it into force. Chargers go wishbone, and Lane rolls to the near side, has a receiver out there, that's Ahern, and Ahern spins out of bounds.
Oh, and they're gonna not stop the clock. They're not stopping the clock. They're saying that he did not get out of bounds. They will stop it long enough to move the down markers. You'll see quickly Lane coming to the sidelines, throws the football right here. They say his forward progress is stopped before he get out of bounds. The clock is still running. It's 41 seconds to go here as Ansonia's ready to play.
Ansonia's wide receivers either side of the field. Lane throws out to D'Onofrio, the far side, and D'Onofrio gets out of bounds inside the Derby 30.
No question about that one. As D'Onofrio got himself out of bounds, short of the first down, but will stop the clock. Lane just hitting him as he turns out to the sidelines. D'Onofrio catching the football, getting all he can get before he gets to the out of bounds marker with 31 seconds left to go here on the 29-yard line.
And Ansonia has a 2nd and 2 coming up, but the clock is more important to the Chargers at this point. Lane again throwing, gets it out to D'Onofrio. D'Onofrio trying to get out of bounds, does not at the 22. Coaching staff is screaming at the Ansonia to get back on the ball.
The referee stopping the clock now. Move the down mark. You'll see right here, D'Onofrio cannot get out of bounds. And Lane is back in business here with 19 seconds left to go.
The line of scrimmage is the 22. Lane again throwing. Has to look into the end zone sooner or later. Incompleted pass broken up by King. Right in the end zone. David D'Onofrio, the intended receiver. Great defensive effort by all Housatonic defensive back Chris King.
King's playing center field in that zone defense, and D'Onofrio came across on a slant in right toward the goal posts, and King was just waiting there and batted the ball down. They've got a 2nd down there. Right here, Chris King or James Lane can throw the ball into the end zone. They've got 12 seconds, possibly 2 plays. If they stretch, possibly they might get 3, but they should be able to get 2 as long as somebody gets out of bounds or they get an incompletion.
2nd and 10, Lane again firing downfield. It is picked off by the Raiders. Back to the 10, Patinilla to the 20, and finally wrapped up at the 22.
Pagnello.
The Derby Red Raiders and Greg Pagnello picked off Lane's pass right at the goal line. And that's...
You see here, Ahern goes to the outside. You won't pick it up in your picture, but there's going to be no one around the football. The ball is tipped by King. Pagnello picks it off. Ahern went out to the outside marker and was not there. Had to be a problem with communication, but this is going to bring an end to this first half. A great first half, Edward.
And what a first half it has been, Buddy Chernovitz. And there you have it, our first half and our score. Ansonia 14, Derby 13. Back with the halftime activities right after this.
You're watching Cable 10, the community channel.
We're at halftime here at Jarvis Field at Ansonia. Our score is Ansonia 14 and Derby 13. And across the field, those are the Ansonia pom-pom girls.
Down in the field, Buddy Chernovich is with the director of athletics for Ansonia High School, Sean Supp. Buddy?
Thank you, Ed. Down at halftime, we have Sean Supp, athletic director in Ansonia. And Sean, you promised to talk a little bit about the new setup in the Naugatuck Valley League and the divisions that you now have. How does it break down?
Okay, what they've done is we've switched our divisions into a large and small. And they did it by taking the Thanksgiving Day opponents. And the larger school of the Thanksgiving Day opponents would go into the large division. The smaller school would go into the smaller division. So we've broken it down into two divisions, five teams in each division. In our division, we have ourselves, Ansonia, we have Sacred Heart, we have Watertown, we have Wolcott, and we have Kennedy. The large division, you have the rest of the NVL teams. They broke it down where, by division record, they will have a championship game on the Thursday before Thanksgiving. It'll be a night game at Municipal Stadium, and the winners of the two divisions will play off for the league championship.
That's an excellent situation, I know, for everyone in the league. Have you at Ansonia lost any traditional rivalries because of the changes?
No, we haven't, and that's why we did ask for the change from the league. The league was very good to us, and they helped us out. The football coaches helped us out by dividing up the league and setting up the schedule. We told them we had a problem by inviting Wolcott into the league. We were going to have 9 games within the league. We only can have a 10-game schedule, so we had a problem. Because we played Shelton and Derby outside of our league schedule, and we wanted to keep both. They're traditional games. We've played them for years and years, and we wanted to keep on doing so. So we asked the league to help us out, and they helped us very well.
Sean, that breaks down very well for you, and I know the Chargers are certainly looking forward, shooting for that game on Thanksgiving, the week before Thanksgiving. I thank you for stopping by, and again, you guys have been super to us, and we'll see you a little bit later.
Thank you, but it's always a pleasure to be here.
Thank you very much, Buddy. Once again, our halftime score at Jarvis Field is Ansonia 14, Derby 13. Back with the second half kickoff right after these words.
Welcome back,
everyone. Set in a couple of moments for the second half kickoff. It'll be Ansonia kicking off to Derby, and we have our first half statistics. Buddy?
Throwing of Ansonia has been the key, pretty much even all the way down the line, 6 first downs apiece. Total yard is 215 for the Ansonia Chargers, 155 for Derby, as we're ready to play.
Artie Politowski's kick coming down in the vicinity of Chris King. He fields the kickoff and brings it back to his 28-yard line.
Tackle by number 83
on the tackle for Ansonia, Damon Perry, a first-year senior for Coach Jack Hunt. And the Red Raiders take over first and 10 on this perfect day for high school football on our Cable 10 Sports Valley High School Football Game of the Week. Ansonia leads it by a scant 1 point. We open up things in the second half of play. It's King in motion. The give is Del Moro. Del Moro tries to slide off the left side, still on his feet. Good balance by Del Moro. He was hit at the line of scrimmage by McClellan and finally put down by Marty Politowski.
Excellent wave drive right here. Watch Del Moro, the fullback right here. He is ready to go down, pushes forward for an extra 5 yards, and a big first down play for the Derby Red Raiders as we begin the second half.
And it's second and short for Coach Charlie DeCenzo's big red team. The line of scrimmage is the 36. Straight handoff, McGee. Stopped by Gumas from his backer position.
Hold them, guys, hold them.
Ansonia struck first in this contest. 2 first quarter touchdowns via the pass route. 66-yard pass from Lane to Jeff Billing. And then later on in the quarter, Lane hit Harold Bell. But the Red Raiders came storming back in the second quarter, and they owned the second quarter. Third and short for the Raiders. That is Del Moro with the first down as he bangs people. Loose football and a scramble for the ball. The Raiders had it initially. Let's see who comes up with the football. Ansonia has the football. Harold Bell fell on the football for the Chargers.
Del Moro, an excellent job running right here, but he's going to get hit. The ball was actually hit out of his hand. And you see the scramble for the football. The Chargers are going to recover about the 44-yard line. And excellent field position on that turnover. Del Moro did not cause it himself. The ball was just knocked out of his hand by someone's helmet.
And a correction on the recovery. It was Callahan falling on the loose football for Ansonia. Hendricks picks his way forward, maintains some good balance himself as he crosses the Raider 40-yard line.
Hendricks straight ahead. They've only had 15 yards in that whole first half rushing, but right here, Hendricks picks up about 5 yards on an excellent run over that left tackle into that Derby secondary. And again, that large amount of fan support that the Ansonia Chargers have is very visible as they are ready to go.
Second down play. Hendricks again down to the 35-yard line, shy of the yardage needed for the first down by a couple. Todd Hunter, sophomore defensive linebacker for the Raiders, on the stop. So it'll be third and one with the line of scrimmage, the Raider 35-yard line. Just underway in this, the second half of play. Ansonia holds a 14-13 point lead in this traditional battle between these two neighboring towns. Hendricks again gets the first down. He cracks down to the 32-yard line. Mo Monahan from his rover back position made the stop for the Raiders.
Watch Hendricks, lead blocked by Gumas inside as Hendricks gets the necessary yardage for the first down. Ball right in the center of the field, about the 32-yard line. James Lane in excellent control of his offensive team.
First down carry for the Chargers. That is Hendricks swinging wide to the right side. Stopped at the line of scrimmage by Angeletti coming up from his linebacker spot. We've had a report.
Watch Angeletti come from the inside out here. As Gomez kicking to the outside, you see Angeletti behind him, and as Hendricks turns upfield, he is right there to wrestle him down. Mark Angeletti, excellent play. Picked up less than a half a yard. Brings about a second and nine for the Charger offense.
And you mentioned Mark Angeletti. That reminds me to tell our viewers that we will be awarding the Fitzpatrick's Player of the Game Award at the conclusion of this football game. Angeletti was our first recipient this year. Ahern on the down and out pattern inside the 25 for the Chargers. Greg Patinella on the coverage.
Very close to that first down yardage necessary. As you see the turnout.
Greg Patinella.
For Ansonia, Chris Ahern will just come to the near sideline. Lange puts it right in his numbers. Great throw as Patinella dragging him out of bounds. Just short of that first down yardage. 31 right here early in this third quarter.
Ansonia has a little bit of shuffling to do in the line. And we'll get to that when we get a chance. John Coughlin has been knocked out of this football game. Hendricks is knocked down by Luchow. Oh, what a hit in the backfield. Chris Luchow.
Chris Luchow was sitting here in the off-tackle hole, as you see. The down block, who was trying to kick out, there's Luchow. He was not blocked, and he is going to create a fourth and about three for the Chargers here, as that's a big defensive play, and it may force Ansonia to throw the ball rather than being able to run.
And how? I formation, fourth and three. Lane is going to throw. It is incomplete. A diving attempt by Harvey goes incomplete, and the Raiders will take over on downs.
That's a big defensive series for Derby, fumbling the football on their own 44-yard line. Ansonia brought the ball down inside the 25, but the Derby Red Raider defense held on a big fourth down play. Harvey just unable to hold on to the football. It was out of his reach. He made a great try for it, but the Derby Red Raiders now have the ball on their own 24-yard line here in their second possession of the second half.
So it is a first down coming up for the Red Raiders. The line of scrimmage is their own 24-yard line. Second possession for the Raiders in the second half. Straight handoff. Getting through is Del Moro to the 37-yard line before, 37-yard line before he stopped there.
Tackle made by number 55.
Watch Del Moro here. He's hit at the line of scrimmage, but he's low enough to break the tackle. You see his leg drive as he comes out close to the 36-yard line. And great leg drive, great run on that first down. Call for the Derby Raiders and gets them a little bit of breathing room as they were backed up inside their own 25.
Mangato on the stop for the Chargers, but not before the Raiders have picked up a first down. Have improved that field position, 37-yard line. The pitch, Chris King coming up as the defense. King eludes a couple of the Chargers, strings it out, and does one fine job of running before the Chargers corral him.
That was a great job, though, by Brett Harvey. Watch Harvey right here, set up shop, and he is the man that forces King to go to the outside. You see him down on the ground, 33. He was down, took two blockers with him, and King is unable to get around the corner after Harvey really closed the corner off to him. And great job by number 33, Brett Harvey, on defense.
And Hendricks cleaned up on the for the Chargers on Chris King, and it's a second and long now for the Raiders. Split backs. And a give inside Del Moro for some hard-fought yardage through the center of the line before he's wrapped up by backer Dan McClellan.
Del Moro's been knocking in there for that tough yardage all day on that trap and those real tough plays. He's done a great job for them, as you see Jimmy Delavolpe right there yelling to that defensive secondary.
Third and 11 for the Raiders. They have the football at their 36-yard line. King goes in motion, reverses his field. Picarello wants to throw on third down as King overthrows King at the 45. Kolatowski on the coverage for the Chargers. Helped out also by the gentleman in your picture, Dave D'Onofrio.
Watch King. Now, he's covered pretty well as Tony Picarello sets up. Overthrows him. Never really had a chance to get the football, but he's well covered in there. And the ball is thrown to the near sidelines and sets up a fourth and about 11 for the Derby Red Raiders.
So Jim Albert will be punting the football away for Coach Charlie DeCenzo's team. A high snap from center, but he gets it off. And it's going to take an Ansonia roll and finally touched by one of the Raiders at the Ansonia 46. We've got a timeout in the action and we'll take a timeout. The score, Ansonia 14, Derby 13. Welcome back, everyone. The midpoint of the third quarter of play. 6:14 showing on the scoreboard clock, although the official time, we repeat, is kept on the field. Ansonia's had to make a couple of adjustments in the offensive line. Kumo is now playing the right tackle spot. Eric Roque has gone in a guard, necessitated by the loss of two-way tackle John Coughlin.
By number 71,
Winston Dawson on the tackle of Hendricks.
Ansonia has not been able to crank that running attack up. They are missing one man at the point of attack, and the Derby Red Raiders have done a great job of containing the run. They have not done as well on the pass, but they certainly have cut the run down, and if they can control that pass, they're going to be in good shape in the second half.
Second and nine for Ansonia. Lane under a rush, reversing his field, throws it. Complete to Ahern at midfield. And in thus doing that, Lane averted a big, big loss on the play. Patinella on the coverage for the Raiders.
How Lane finds Ahern here is unbelievable. Watch him. He's going to be chased around here. Thought he could get to the outside. He's cut back off. Right here, he stops, and he finds Ahern, who does a great job coming back to the football. Patinella staying with him for the tackle. But a great play preventing, as Eddie said, a big loss on that play. It creates a third and about seven for the Chargers right here, and it's a definite throwing situation.
Third and seven for Ansonia. Two wideouts at the bottom part of your picture. In motion, that is Hendricks. Single setback is Gomez. Lane, being pressured from both ends, gets the pass downfield, incomplete, out of the reach of the diving Fran Hendricks.
Incomplete.
Hendricks showed great speed as he got behind Chris King that time. The ball was just a little bit out of his hand. You'll see here Lane gets great pressure inside. He released the ball just before he's hit, but behind Hendricks, Hendricks got behind both McGee and King, but unable to reach the football as it's a fourth down, and Lane is going back to punt the football. Derby Red Raiders will get it back for the third time in this third quarter.
James Lane standing at his 35-yard line, gets the snap from center, a big rush by the Raiders, and Lane gets a spiral off in the direction of Sherwin at the 15. And Sherwin met head-on at the 25-yard line.
Ball run back by number 21, Josh Sherwin.
Lane does a good job getting the ball away. You see here, 21 for Derby, catching the football. He does a great job just coming straight up the field and getting all that he can get out of that with excellent coverage by the special teams unit of the Ansonia Chargers.
So the Red Raiders on Sherwin's return take over at their 26-yard line. First and 10 for the Raiders, down by a point. Third quarter action. Ray McGee with the football.
Number 14, Chris King.
Chris King, the ball carrier.
By number 23, Fran Hendricks.
Number 23, Fran Hendricks, now playing in the secondary for Ansonia on the tackle for the Chargers. So Kane, a good bit of yardage on the first down carry, gets a 7, and the line of scrimmage now the 32. I formation for the Raiders. King again gets the call, wrapped up this time by Stallings at the line of scrimmage.
Tackle by number 79, Ramondo Stallings.
I think you're seeing Jack Hunt make some substitutions here, getting Hendricks in there for speed. As you see the ball handed off right here to McGee, or to King, McGee leading, unable to break the initial tackle, short of the first down yardage, bringing up a big third down and about 3-4 of the Red Raiders. Jack Hunt getting some speed into that secondary to prevent anyone from breaking a big play.
Third and 3 for the Raiders, an important play for them, the handoff, and it's going to be close to the yardage for the first down. That was Mark Del Moro, and we'll await the spots at the 36.
He's going to come up about less than a foot here, I think, short of the first down, similar to the way it has been all afternoon for the Red Raiders. They have been just about a foot short on a number of these big third down plays.
There will be a big man to play.
Fourth down for the Red Raiders as they are going to, they got it this time, and it is a big third down play for them.
You were saying?
I thought they were about a foot short.
It's time for that annual visual checkup. First down for the Raiders. Football at the 37. Full house backfield. Chris King barrels off the left side, crosses the 40-yard line, met there by monster back Marty Politowski.
Watch King just bust in here tough off tackle. He's getting good blocks at the point of attack, and then noses forward for another 5 yards and an excellent first down play for the Red Raiders as they are knocking off pretty good chunks of yardage here with that running attack all afternoon.
Greg Goom has also assisted on the last tackle. The Raiders picking up some good yardage on first down, second and 6. Football at the 41. King goes in motion. McGee to center of the line for a pair. That whole middle of the Ansonia line on the tackle. Kumo and Dan McClellan, the primary tacklers for Ansonia.
The game is a complete contrast offensively. The Chargers unable to run the football. 15 yards in that first half. The Red Raiders, one pass completion in the first half, a big one. Touchdown, Chris King catching the football, but Red Raiders are run conscious. Chargers have been pass conscious today.
Third down play, Picarello at the line of scrimmage. Gives it to King, and King will not get the first down on the third down carry. Stop short of it. The line of scrimmage coming up at the 45. Mungato on the tackle for Ansonia.
Lead by number 55, Harvey Mungato, and number 50, Angelo Kumo.
Fourth and yard, and you can see the large crowd again as you get a wide panoramic view of the Jarvis Field press box and the large crowd here to witness an outstanding football game. 1:09 left to go in this third quarter.
Albert back to punt the football at his 30-yard line and gets the kick off in the direction of Hendricks. Hendricks catches the football. No fair catch called for, and Hendricks is stopped at the 20-yard line. And with the break in the action, let's take a look back at one of our former Valley High School football stars on our high school hero salute.
Cable 10 Sports proudly presents High School Hero Salute. Ike Red Adanti was an outstanding two-way performer for the Ansonia Lavender 30 years ago. His guard linebacker, a tri-captain for Coach Charles Booch Jarvis in 1957, received Sporting News All-American and All-Valley honors. Red was also named as Ansonia's most valuable player and was a starter in Connecticut's first ever All-Star Nutmeg Bowl. Mike went on to Southern Connecticut State University, where he led the Owls as a co-captain under Coach Jess Dow. Adanti began his professional career as a teacher in the Ansonia school system and later served as the city's mayor. Mike is currently the president at his alma mater, Southern Connecticut State University. Mike Red Adanti, Cable 10 Sports salutes you.
Welcome back, everyone. Ansonia has the football, the line of scrimmage at their 21-yard line. Under a minute to go, according to the scoreboard clock, and that is very, very close, of course, to the official time. Wishbone for the Chargers.
Number
give is to D'Onofrio, stopped by Monahan. As one of the Raiders gets up slowly, and now they're going to, the officials are going to call timeout.
There's an official. Kind of that wishbone. Gumas lead block and Hendricks, D'Onofrio getting the football ahead for about a 3 to 4 yard gain as. Down on the ground is number 42, Mo Monahan, for the Derby Red Raiders.
Sean Monahan.
Monahan now getting up, and it's always a good sign. He gets up and actually starting a run off the field under his own power. And checking in for Mo will be Jamie Gagnon on the Derby defensive unit. So the Chargers went to the wishbone. Let's see if they stay in the wishbone now and try to grind out some yardage and improve their field position. And in the they do come out for the wishbone. Halfbacks in the wishbone, D'Onofrio and Hendricks. The up back is Gumas, and that is Hendricks, who slides his way to the 30-yard line, close to the first down, before he's stopped by Jamie Gagnon.
They're just running that power formation, coming off the left side with the lead blocks of both Hendricks and Gumas. And as this third quarter ends, we have had punts and more punts, but no one able to cross the goal line. And we are ready to begin that fourth quarter, Edward.
Our third quarter score, Ansonia 14, Derby 13. Start the fourth quarter of play, Ansonia has the football at their 30-yard line, shy about 2 feet of the first down. A tight wishbone formation, and Lane takes it straight ahead, still on his feet as he gets to the 35, and the Chargers will have picked up an important first down.
When in doubt, you give it to your toughest runner. That time, James Lane got his nose forward for about 5 yards. Almost broke it, really, at that point. As he got the necessary yardage for the first down around the 34-and-a-half yard line.
Adelino tied up Lane at that point. First down, but he said the line of scrimmage, the 34. Bell checks in, and Lane positions Bell, and time might become a factor for the Chargers. Wishbone formation. Hendricks is knifed under in the backfield, pouring through for the Raiders. Mark Angeletti.
Angeletti comes on a blitzer. You see him start at the top of your screen and no one picks him up. He gets Hendrick in the backfield for a 3 yard loss. And that's a big play against that wishbone. Forcing that bone here to drive 13 yards in two plays is going to be tough for that Ansonia offensive line as they are not in four down territory right here. And the Red Raiders would love to get that ball back in good field position, trying to get down close enough for another score to get that lead.
Line of scrimmage is the Ansonia 32-yard line. I formation for the Chargers. Lane is going to throw, put it up. It is incomplete, dropped at the 40-yard line. Ahern was the intended receiver. Pettinella on the coverage for Derby.
Just the turnout again. You see Lane just stop, throw the football out of the reach of Chris Ahern as he goes down, cannot hold on to it. And it creates a third and a very long 12 to 13 yards here for the Chargers. They need the first down in order to maintain possession of the football.
Third down for Ansonia, line of scrimmage, their own 32, I formation. Two wide receivers out to the left side. Lane, a deep drop, throwing downfield as a receiver out there. It is caught. Harold Bell, oh my goodness, down to the 25. Pettinella finally makes the tackle.
That's a great throw. We've got a down, out, and up, return, out, and go. Lane gives that fake to hold the corner, and then Bell just runs down the sidelines, beating Pettinella for a big, again, play. James Lane down to the 25-yard line. Lane to Bell, again, that combination. And a big play and excellent field position right here for the Chargers.
Ansonia at the 25. The pitch, Hendricks picks his way. Center of the field. Hendricks gets down to the 20-yard line before he's stopped by Angeletti.
Number 23, Brady Hendricks. Tackle made by number 54, Mark Angeletti.
Pitch to Hendricks, the kickout block right here. Gumas, and then down inside that 20-yard line for the Charger offense. as the Chargers right here can smell a victory. Another score for them right here will give them a little breathing room. As there's miscommunication, they're going to be forced to use one of their timeouts, which may come back at the end to haunt them, unable to get that play in.
But anyway, we have the opportunity in the break in the action. Let's pass along our best wishes to former Seymour High School football star Frank Tricarico, who's recuperating from major heart surgery. Frank played for the Seymour Wildcats in the 1960 to 1962 era. So our best wishes go out for the quick, speedy recovery of Frank Tricarico.
Here's a big guy on the sidelines for those Chargers. Number 79 for Ansonia.
Raimondo Stallings,
who has worked himself into the starting lineup and done a creditable job this afternoon in this very big game. Big game to break into that starting lineup.
Second down for Ansonia. Line of scrimmage is the Derby 19-yard line. Last quarter, Ansonia holds a slim one-point lead. They lead it 14-13. And we just could not have asked for a better day weather-wise for high school football. Chargers go I formation. D'Onofrio the flanker. Hendricks picks his way at the line of scrimmage. Will just be lucky to get back to the line of scrimmage. Stopped by Battalino along with Todd Hunter.
Ball carried by Grant Hendricks. Tackle lead by Todd Hunter. And Mark
Ball is just countered back to Hendricks, and he goes nowhere as that Derby again defense has held strong against the run all day today.
Third and five for Ansonia. D'Onofrio goes in motion on the third down play. Lane looking to throw, incomplete. I think the ball might have been tipped.
Ball was tipped right at the line of scrimmage, either by Rizzio or one of the other Derby football players. You see as Lane comes out, somebody's gonna get a hand up in here as he releases the ball. Right there, it's tipped, and that was Rizzio who tipped the football, preventing the reception. Brings up a fourth and five. And right here, a lot of this football game is gonna depend on what the Chargers are able to do on offense and the Red Raiders are able to counter with on defense.
D'Onofrio was the intended receiver, and covering on the play for Derby was Chris King. Fourth and five. Lane looking, throwing, caught, Ahern. And I believe he has the first down, Chris Ahern.
Watch Lane sit back here and wait till the last moment before he throws the football, and then Ahern with those big hands right there over the middle. Patinella on him, but enough yardage for the first down, close to the 10-yard line here. Is a great throw and catch from James Lane to Chris Ahern.
Patinella along with Kevin Burns on the stop for the Raiders. The line of scrimmage is the throw. The Chargers go back to the wishbone. The Raiders dig in defensively. Hendricks spins his way down to the 8-yard line. The going is tough on the run for the Chargers. Mo Monahan back into the football game on the tackle for the Raiders.
Hendricks has to be a little disappointed today. He has not had the running room that he's had in the first five football games, but to his credit, he has been busting in there hard every time he's gotten the football. And it's coming out of that bone. He is looking for that key block to break it and to get it to the end zone.
Line of scrimmage is the nine. Lane wants to throw, pumps once, gets it out to the release man, incomplete. Patinella on the defensive gem. Loomis was the safety valve.
That was a textbook way to play that pass. Patinella waited over Goomis' shoulder and just batted the ball down. No contact. Great play here. As you see the rollout, Goomis coming out of the backfield, out of the bone. And right here, look at that ball just over the shoulder, knocking the ball down. It's a big third down play right here. They can get the first down. They were about 8 yards short of that first down. Around the 1 yard line, they could convert that first down if they get that close.
Chargers in an obvious passing formation. Out to the left side, D'Onofrio along with the Ahern. Split backs, Lane is the quarterback. In motion, goes Hendricks. Lane, looking to throw, has a rush, gets it into the end zone. Touchdown,
was a great play by Brett Harvey, who was arcing off the line of scrimmage. Harvey comes off the line of scrimmage. He arcs outside to widen. You got Hendricks in motion, and you got a one-on-one situation right here, and Harvey's able to get inside and make a great catch. And that is a big play right here, but this extra point now is going to be key, because a two-point play will put the game out of reach. A one-point play will give the Derby Red Raiders a chance to come back with a two-point play and tie it. So if Ansonia chooses the 1 point, they will allow Derby the chance to tie, and they are doing that.
The placement, the kick, it is good. So Brent Harvey on the reception from 9 yards out from James Lane, and Halleck's extra point gives Ansonia an 8-point margin with 7:58 remaining. And our score, Ansonia 21, Derby 13, back after these words. Welcome back, everyone. There you see Jack Hunt, first-year coach for the Chargers, looking on anxiously. Belatowski approaches the football. Line drive, kickoff. Coming down in the vicinity of Pettinella. Pettinella trying to get wide. Mike Thunder at the 20. Roke covering for Ansonia.
Excellent coverage on the special teams. Pettinella tried to wait for the ball to go out of bounds. Couldn't wait any longer. Picked it up and tried to get into the wall, but could not get back far enough. Turned it up. Unable to get to the 20-yard line. A little short, but 7:43 left to go. A lot of time, and the Derby Red Raiders now cranking it up.
First down, line of scrimmage, the 19-yard line. Del Moro breaks it at the line of scrimmage, but then stopping him is Pelotowski with a defensive gem. If Pelotowski were not there, Del Moro had an awful lot of free real estate in front of him.
He might have made a bad decision in cutting to the sidelines rather than keeping it straight ahead. But it's tough to do when you're 11 guys in blue chasing you, and he's done an outstanding job all afternoon as he gets about 5 yards for that first down carry.
Raiders have the football at their 23-yard line. Second and 6 coming up. Picarello throwing on second down as a receiver. It is incomplete. Knocked down by Hendricks. Going for the football was Andy Cota for the Raiders.
And that's one of the reasons why Jack Hunt has made that substitution. He's got that speed at the corner, preventing anyone from running by, as Chris King did earlier, running by his cornerback, as Hendricks is right there to knock the ball down. And that's the difference in speed and a little bit of security for Jack Hunt, knowing that no one is going to outrun those corners and get that big play.
Third and 6 for the Raiders. In motion, King, the pitch out, Ray McGee. McGee gets to the outside, close to the yard it's needed for the first down, but I believe he's shy about a yard. McClellan on the tackle for the Chargers.
The Chargers have held here, bringing up that fourth down as McGee will try to the outside. You see Angeletti getting in front of him. Good lead block, but not enough to get that first down yardage, as it will force the punt. And it will allow the Chargers again now to get possession and run some time off that clock. As you look at that sideline, and they are right now in Charger country, starting to feel very good about this 8-point lead with less than seven minutes left to play.
Albert punts it away, and Hendricks does, I was going to say the wise thing, but I know you really want to feel that punt, buddy. I don't think Hendricks wanted to fool around with the ball and risk a fumble. And the ball took a dirty roll, getting down to the Ansonia 16-yard line. Coach, what
an
do you
excellent, excellent punt, and it's certainly going to give Derby an opportunity if they can hold the Chargers here to get pretty good field position for what might be their last opportunity to get back in this game and to tie it up. It's been an excellent game. The missed extra point certainly must have taken its toll on Derby, being so close to the tie. As you see Charlie DeCenzo going over his offensive play sheet, getting ready for an opportunity to get the football back and try and get into the end zone.
High formation, the pitch, that's Hendricks. Trying to turn the corner, the Raiders come up to meet the play. Hendricks is lucky to get back to the line of scrimmage on the first down carry. And Buddy, if our viewers are interested in this football game, if it is a tie game in regulation, both these programs will go to a Kansas tiebreaker system. Rizzio made the initial hit for the Raiders on the
First down play for Ansonia. Second and 10 for Ansonia, deep in their own territory. Split backs, nothing fancy, as Dumas, with some little extra effort, gets it for about 3 yards. Stopped again by number 26, Rizzio.
And while we have an opportunity, I'd just like to compliment the officials in this football game. They have allowed these young men to play football. There have not been a lot of flags. There's been a lot of good hitting. They had one personal foul early and established the fact that it was going to be a clean game. They were not going to let them get away with anything. It's really been a quality game and an outstanding job and tone set by the four officials on this game.
Wide receivers out of your screen to the out to the right side. Lane under a rush on third down. Releases it over the middle. D'Onofrio. D'Onofrio at the 42 of Ansonia and almost broke it before King and Patanella made the stop.
D'Onofrio found a hole in the zone. He just sat there and waited for Lane to find him. Watch Lane come back. He will survey the field. He finds him sitting in that little opening and almost breaks it. D'Onofrio almost goes all the way as he made the catch, got the first down yardage, and then turned it up the field. And creates very excellent field position right now, Rainier. He's taken away from Derby that good field position they might have had if they held him. And right now we're going to have an official's timeout for a moment as Russ Hansen watching Brent Harvey fix part of his helmet. And that field position now is lost to the Red Raiders. They have to get the football back right here with 4:17 left to go and need an excellent drive in order to get down into that end zone.
Brent Harvey has solved his problems with his helmet and will resume play here as the Chargers have the football at their 43 and a first down coming up. Tight wishbone formation. The give, Hendricks. Hit in the backfield, Angeletti just outstanding, and we've got a little extracurricular activity out on the field, but the officials jump in quickly.
Not only that, both teams pulling their players back into their huddle. It's very emotional out there. Both teams certainly have played their hearts out, and Angeletti that time came through untouched again into the backfield. Took Hendricks down before he could get to the line of scrimmage, and Mark Angeletti has had a great game for the Derby Red Raiders. It's unfortunate that one of these football teams has to walk off the field a loser, because in this type of game, they've both played their hearts out and they both deserve to be winners. They're quality programs.
Both teams coming into this traditional battle undefeated with identical 5-0 records. The pitch again, Hendricks out of the wishbone. Hendricks back to the original line of scrimmage and one more to the 45 before number 54, Angeletti, pays another call, helped out by Luchow.
I'll tell you, I hate to play the team that loses next week after this football game, because that team is going to have a long week and they're certainly going to probably pay their respects to the team that they play on their schedule next week.
Harold Bell checks in from the sidelines with the play from the sidelines, from the coaches.
Big play right here, third and nine. Ansonia not afraid to throw the football.
And we've got a flag, and that might be for too much time, and that's what it's going to be.
Ansonia is penalized for the live game. 5-yard penalty.
And you see in your picture, James Dellavolpe, Jimmy Dellavolpe, in talking to Harold Bell. And a little bit of look of disgust in assistant coach Jimmy Dellavolpe's face. Why did we have to take that much time? Third and long, football at the 40-yard line of Ansonia. Trying to hold on to the football. The Raiders trying to stop the Chargers and get one last chance. Lane on a passing situation. Under a rush, Lane is going to be brought down at the 30-yard line. Winston Dawson led the charge from his middle guard position.
Watch Lane now go back. He's unable to find the receivers. He gets very good pressure inside. And rather than throw the ball up, he takes the sack, which a quality quarterback will do. There's a time when you have to eat the football. James Lane did that. Derby takes their first timeout with 2:21 left to go here in this fourth quarter, and they need field position right here, a good return, and then their offense is going to have one chance to score those 8 points to get themselves a tie. And there you see the Chargers and positions of many of those Ansonia Chargers on one of the many signs around this football stadium today.
And as we look around here at Jarvis Field, no one is heading for the exits. They're all staying here at Jarvis Field. The thousands and thousands of people that annually flock to this big traditional battle.
And you don't have to go very far to get here. Two towns back to back, very close. And this game is talked about from today until next year's game.
Timeout is still in effect on the field. Scoreboard clock showing 2:44 and awfully close to the actual time. Lane is the punter. The Raiders will be coming. They are. And Lane gets it off. It's a short punt, but there's not going to be a return. It's going to go out of bounds, and the Raiders will have it at their 40.
60 yards away from tying this football game up. Enough time. They have two timeouts. They only have one pass completion today, and that certainly is going to sit on the minds of that Ansonia defense, the fact that they've got to contain the run. The Red Raiders have not been able to throw the football except for that one completion for the touchdown to King. And so right now I think the Charger defense is going to try and or is prepared for the run first. The pass is not going to come unless it's a third down or a second and long.
Line of scrimmage is the 41. In motion, King. The quarterback is Picariello. Picariello looking to throw, running the football, stopped and hammered at the line of scrimmage. Brent Harvey.
Watch Harvey hold his ground right here, number 33. Plays off the block and then just steps back inside, takes Picariello to the ground. An excellent job. Harvey's had a great football game. He has contained and closed that end off all day. An excellent catch on that touchdown. He's a quality football player.
Loss of one on the play, second and 11 for the Raiders. Again, King in motion. Harvey pressuring Picariello. Picariello throwing downfield. Gets a reception from Jamie Gagnon at the 49-yard line.
Close to that first down yardage, it's going to make it a makeable third down play. As you see him outrun, but Harvey's still keeping contained. Notice how he breaks back to get him before he gets to the corner. But an excellent throw by Picariello to Gagnon. And they're going to have about 33 here as the clock continues to move. 140, 142 left to go here in this final period.
Third and two, the line of scrimmage, the 49. A single setback. Gagnon in motion for the Raiders. The pitch out, that's McGee trying to cut the corner. Stringing the play out for the Chargers, Greg Dumas. What a defensive play by Dumas.
Dumas held his ground. When you've got a guy like right here, McGee coming around the corner. Now he's got great speed. He gets outside and watch Dumas. Dumas just goes right after him, pulls him down, and it's a fourth and three. As you see, Dumas, who has played an outstanding football game, fullback on offense, and that inside linebacker on defense out of that 40 or when they're in that 50. And Derby has taken a timeout right here. This play for the Derby Red Raiders is the football game. Without a first down, it's all over.
So we come down to this, as you see the jubilant Ansonia side of the field. It is Ansonia up by a score of 21-13. The Raiders, when we resume play, will have a fourth and three. Line of scrimmage, they're 48. And if, as Buddy said, if the Chargers get the football, if the Raiders do not convert, the Chargers will just run out the clock.
And if Jack Hunt could get on the ballot this week in the Ansonia, he's liable to win the election. Last year, they struggled. One of the signs at the end of the field, the pride is back, Ansonia pride. And certainly they have, in the first 5.5 football games, shown that pride to be a certain factor in playing football.
Here we go, Picariello. Batted down, the pass is batted down at the line of scrimmage. Brent Harvey along with Dumas.
Harvey again, watch him. Right here, he gets his hands up, playing off the block. He knocks the pass down. And that's it for the Derby Red Raiders here, barring a turnover. Derby has one timeout. Ansonia can sit on the football. They do not have to make a first down. The clock will run out with the Chargers ahead in this football game, 21-13.
And that was, let's credit Brent Harvey, all alone, got that big paw up there and knocked the football down. And Harvey scored the touchdown, the third touchdown that gave Ansonia some breathing room. Wishbone Lane drops to the ground. And the Raiders call a timeout.
That's the last one for Derby. 1:14 left to go. Jimmy Delavolpe coming into your pitch, the offensive coordinator. And the Chargers will talk it over. They can sit on the ball. The victory is theirs, barring a mistake.
Lane went down in his backfield on a second down. A loss on the play, of course, of 3 yards. But as you see Jack Hunt in your picture, all Ansonia wants to do now is just run out the clock. Second down. Lane drops back again at the 44-yard line.
Ansonia is trying to now kill the clock.
And the Derby Red Raiders cannot stop the time. They cannot stop the clock. And Ansonia will have a third down coming up. And we've got 54 and counting left in this football game. Down to 50 seconds. Lane again just drops down. And a fourth down coming up for Ansonia. Now, it all depends how much official time. There's the unofficial time on the clock.
It's going to be very close. They may not even have to snap the ball. As you see, the Ansonia Chargers now pretty confident that they don't even have to put the ball in play. Eight seconds left, and it doesn't look like they're going to have to put the ball in play. Yes, they are. All right, the official clock on the field. We've got 3 seconds. Chargers are going to have to snap the football. And the game is over.
And, of course, there is Jack Hunt in the picture, the victorious coach. And coming across to meet him on the other side of the field, Derby head football coach Charlie Vincenzo. So the time has run out on the Derby Red Raiders here at Jarvis Field. As you see the picture of the two close friends, Charlie DeCenzo, the Derby Red Raider head coach, and Jack Hunt of the Ansonia Chargers. Both coaching staffs are very friendly with one another. And that's our final. Ansonia 21, Derby 13. Back with the presentation of the Fitzpatrick's of Ansonia Player of the Game Award right after these messages.
Buddy Chernovitz, this is Ed Clemens saying goodbye, everyone.